Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's your bro. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys all about the for each loop in Java. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. One like equals one prayer for the YouTube algorithm. Hey, what's going on, guys and gals? In this video, I'm going to explain the for each loop, also known as an enhanced for loop. This is a traversing technique to iterate through all the elements in an array or other collection. The benefits is that a for each loop takes less steps and is more readable than a standard for loop. However, it is less flexible. So let's begin by creating an array of animals. So these will be animal names, so the data type will be string. Then we need a set of straight brackets. We will call this array animals equals, and then we will assign a few values. So within our array of animals, let's say we have a cat, a dog, a rat, and a bird. I'm not sure what kind of bird, just use your imagination. Now we could create a for loop to iterate once through each element of this array, but we could also use a for each loop to do this. So this is how to create a for each loop. Type for, a set of parentheses, and then a set of curly braces. So the only part that is different is the statements within the parentheses of the for loop. We're going to begin by listing the data type of our array or other collection. So we're going to list this as string because we're iterating through strings. Next, we need an index. Let's say index I, then colon. Colon represents the word in. For every string index in our array of animals. So lastly, list the array or collection name at the end. So this will iterate once for each index in our array of animals. So what would we like to do within each iteration of this for each loop? Let's display whatever I is. So this is going to be a string, whatever this data type is. So we can print this directly. And when we run this, our for each loop will display all the elements within our array. And now let's try this for each loop using a collection. An ArrayList is a type of collection. So let's create an ArrayList called animals this time. So ArrayList, within angle brackets, we're going to list the data type, which is string. And then we will call this animals equals new array list, angle brackets, list the data type, parentheses, semicolon. And then we'll need an import at the top, import java.util.arraylist. And then we need to add some values to each element of this array list. Animals.add. We're going to add a cat, then repeat the process for dog, rat, and bird. Dog, rat, and bird. And you can see that nothing has changed. So remember, a for each loop is useful for iterating through all of the elements in an array or other collection. It involves less steps and is more readable, but it's less flexible compared to a standard for loop. So that is everything you need to know to get started with the for each loop, also known as the enhanced for loop. If you would like a copy of all this code, I will post all of this in the comments down below. And don't forget to do me a favor and smash that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.